B-21 radar is publicly revealed, next most important thing is flight test. B-21 radar test pilots explain about upcoming first flight. It will be the first test flight of a new American bomber in 33 years. That's when the B-2 Spirit, the world's first stealth bomber, took off from Northrop Grumman's sprawling and high-security production facility at Plant 42 in Palmdale, and landed 112 minutes later at Edwards Air Force Base. There it would enter into developmental flight testing with the 420th Flight Test Squadron. Sometime next year, if all goes according to plan, Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Clifton Bell and Northrop Grumman test pilot Chris Moss are expected to be the first to take the B-21 Raider into the air, making the first flight of the deep, penetrating bomber designed to be the most advanced stealth warplane ever built. "There are a few things in your career that you never expect to happen," said Bell, commander of the 420th Flight Test Squadron, which was reactivated 3 years ago to plan, test, analyze and report on all flight and ground testing of the B-21 Raider. "You make choices based on what you think's good for you and your family and also what's good for why you put on the uniform to begin with and for the nation. And sometimes you get opportunities like this. I had the opportunity to fly the B-52, the oldest bomber in our inventory, one of the oldest aircraft in our inventory," Bell added. "And then I flew the B-2, which we have behind us here, an exceptional airplane. And then having the opportunity to bring forward the next generation of bomber is a very exciting opportunity. It's unknown at the moment exactly when that opportunity will take place. Air Force and Northrop Grumman officials have not set a firm date yet for its first flight. It's all part of an effort by Northrop Grumman, which won the contract to develop the B-21 in 2015 to fulfill the Air Force's desire to conduct flight tests with a more mature, largely production representative bomber as opposed to a still relatively experimental one. One of the key tenets of the program has been risk reduction, and really focusing on doing as much of that testing up front to reduce risk," said Schneider. "The Raider is the first U.S. warplane to be digitally designed and tested from the outset, meaning that Northrop Grumman was able to reduce the risk of developing the plane by making and addressing mistakes in a virtual environment instead of during flight testing. In May 2022, Northrop Grumman successfully completed the first and most critical loads calibration test of the first B-21 aircraft. That test, focusing on calibrating instrumentation prior to flight, and verifying structural integrity, yielded positive and consistent results, according to a Northrop Grumman media release at the time. During testing, the B-21 airframe endures varying percentages of stress to ensure the aircraft can proceed on its path to flight readiness. Loads calibration testing is just the first of the conditions the aircraft has to meet during its ground testing phase. In the coming months, the team will power up the aircraft, test its subsystems, and apply coatings. The next steps will include carrying out engine runs as well as low-speed and high-speed taxi tests, and then on to the first flight. The input of those who will fly the aircraft is a big part of the design process. Among the simulators Bell and Moss have worked on is a handling quality simulator, which allows us to not only evaluate but get comfortable with and understand the flight control systems and how it works on the aircraft, said Bell. "Just basic knowledge of the systems in the aircraft is a good start. Both of us have been on the program a long time, so we have a lot of depth of knowledge on that. But then also being able to execute those systems and know the difference between something going wrong and the way the system operates, we spent a lot of time in simulators working on that. We have actual systems that will be on the actual aircraft that we're flying on a testbed," said Moss. "It's much cheaper to fly. We can fly more often and we're flying it before the actual aircraft is actually flown, so we get an early look at how the systems are integrated. We can fix a lot of problems before it even gets on to the B-21. But more than just getting to know how the systems work, the pilots are helping to develop them. We've actually had the chance to help develop how the flying qualities of the aircraft is going to be," said Moss. "Not just in learning how it flies, but also help. In areas where it might not be great, we help figure out how to make it great," Moss said. "And we've been doing that for at least the last 6 months. We've been doing some extensive simulator evals on the handling qualities. It's one thing to train in simulators and testbeds, but another thing entirely to actually fly an aircraft for the first time. That too is not lost on the test pilots. As it was mentioned earlier, we can't validate the model till we actually go and fly, said Moss. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.